The story begins with Jason Brady, a teenage vlogger and musician. After he greets his followers, he starts performing his created song. At St. Adeline's Catholic School in Los Angeles, his parents have sent him to a Catholic boarding school. His sister, Zoe Brady, an overachiever, also attends the school. Zoe disapproves of Zara Croft, who has a crush on Jason. His father disagrees with his musical ambitions and has ruined his father's automobile over the weekend. Meanwhile, Sister Rebecca, the headmistress, approaches to greet the family and promises to look after Jason's behavior. Sister Sophia, the new nun at the school, is welcomed by Sister Rebecca. Sister Rebecca reviews Sister Sophia's record from her previous teaching at St. Val. She then reveals the school protocol that teachers are not allowed to wear makeup, leading her to have Sister Sophia's makeup removed, which Sister Sophia reluctantly complies with. While Sister Rebecca shows Sister Sophia around the campus, they meet Jason, and Sister Sophia's attraction to the young man is evident. It is revealed that Jason went through a hard time last summer. Zoe prays to God for help for her brother and for admission to her preferred school in Whittendale. Jason ignores his friends to read the comments on his vlog. One comment from Meant to Be says, "You get me. That's Sister Sophia, of course." She makes amends with her laptop while watching his performance and then searches the school for the dork with the guitar. Sister Sophia begins working toward seducing Jason and reapplies her cosmetics. She offers herself as someone to talk to if he ever needs it, which Jason approves of. During class, when Sister Sophia sees the school hottie, Sarah, flirting with Jason, she becomes hostile. To ensure that Sarah and Jason stay apart, she reassigns Sarah's seat in class so she can constantly monitor Sarah's movements. Zoe alerts Sister Sophia that they haven't done their morning prayer and notices that the new teacher isn't participating with the students. Because of this, Zoe immediately reports it to her brother, mentioning something strange about their new teacher, which Jason ignores. As Jason heads to his room, Sophia suddenly approaches him to ask if there is anything going on between him and Sarah. Jason insists that he does not have a girlfriend, which pleases Sophia. When Sister Sophia discovers Jason and Sarah kissing on campus, she threatens Sarah before fiercely clutching her crucifix, causing gushing wounds in her palm. After class, she calls Jason to talk and invites him to come to her chamber for a word. After Jason leaves, she licks her palm like a cat. Upon arriving at her chamber, Sister Sophia begins changing her clothes and deliberately leaves her door open. Jason goes to Sister Sophia's room as instructed and finds the door ajar. He looks inside and sees Sister Sophia applying body oil to her lingerie-clad body. He is turned on, but runs away. That night, Jason couldn't sleep, constantly thinking about what he saw and fantasizing about Sister Sophia. Disturbed, he decides to distance himself from her. While heading home for the weekend, Sophia sees Sarah and Jason being affectionate with each other again. She excuses herself by claiming she needs to visit her supposedly sick aunt. At home, Jason asks his parents for a year off from school to pursue his musical interests, but they react poorly, leading him to skip dinner. Meanwhile, Sister Sophia continues to obsess over and stalk Jason. She watches his parents' house while he plays his guitar. When she overhears him speaking to Sarah, she accidentally bumps into a trash bin, prompting Jason to check it out. Fortunately, she manages to flee and angrily drinks whiskey in her car. Later, she breaks into the girls' dorm and plants a joint in Sarah and Zoe's room. On her way out, she is caught by Sister Rebecca, who demands an explanation. As they argue, Zoe listens and becomes convinced that Sister Sophia is a bad sister. During class, Sister Sophia instructs the students to open their textbooks and discovers the joint in Sarah's textbook. The headmistress suspends Sarah from school. Sophia then suggests conducting a full inspection of the school, which the heads agree to. They conduct room searches and discover booze in Jason's room under his mattress, which he completely denies. It is revealed that Sophia also planted the bottle of alcohol in Jason's room. However, she offers to have Jason's punishment be community service with her, which he agrees to. After that, Father Macy is impressed by what Sophia has shown. When he asks her when she felt her calling, Sophia narrates a different story. In a flashback, her calling is revealed to mean becoming obsessed with Jason. Upon knowing that St. Adeline was hiring a nun from Montana, she stalked the real Sister Sophia, attacked her to death, and impersonated her. Meanwhile, Jason tells his sister how Sophia resolved his suspension, and Zoe decides to stay the weekend to keep an eye on him. Over the weekend, Sister Sophia approaches Jason while he is performing yard work. She plans to keep him busy working in the yard to create an excuse to further seduce him, while Zoe observes. Sophia then sneaks into his room, sets up her cell phone camera to record their encounter, and makes out with him while undressing. Although Jason tries to stop her, knowing it is wrong, he is unable to resist. Sister Sophia covertly films their steamy encounter. The following morning, she coerces Jason into continuing their affair despite his guilt over the event. When she visits Jason's room again, she smells his clothes and is caught by Zoe, who is looking for her brother. Jason's overachieving sister Zoe begins to suspect Sophia, who observes her closely. Sophia sets up Zoe to appear as though she is cheating on an exam, framing her to silence her. Sophia then attempts to get Zoe suspended. Sister Rebecca is understanding and offers Zoe another chance, though she shares Zoe's reservations about the new teacher. Zoe expresses her suspicions about Sophia not participating in prayers, and Sister Rebecca becomes doubtful about what she has heard. Jason goes to confession and expresses his guilt for what he did. As the father departs, Sister Sophia emerges from the confessional booth, and they did it again. Due to Sister Rebecca's doubts, she invites Bishop O'Reilly to the school. During their discussion, the bishop shares Sophia's achievements and heroism with the children. Meanwhile, Sophia overhears this and quickly sneaks away. When she is called to meet the bishop, Sophia tries to escape, but Sister Rebecca sees her leaving in a hurry. Sophia then makes the excuse that she needs to visit her sick aunt again and immediately leaves the school. Jason attends a party where Sarah attempts to sleep with him, but all he can think about is Sister Sophia. He quickly leaves the house, with Sarah chasing after him. While walking, he encounters a patrolling police officer who stops him for holding a bottle of alcohol without any ID. Fortunately, Sister Sophia arrives to vouch for him, and the police let him go. Meanwhile, Jason's father decides to search for him and bring him home. However, Jason has already been taken to Sister Sophia's house. There, Sister Sophia reveals that she has a lot of money and promises to provide for all of Jason's needs if he accompanies her to Paris to escape. Jason refuses, stating that he has no intention of leaving with her and insists that what happened between them was a big mistake and is over. Sister Sophia then blames Sarah for being close to Jason. Jason, however, no longer cares and immediately leaves. He calls Zoe for assistance to pick him up, but Zoe can't help because Dad took the car. Eventually, Jason's father finds him sitting along the street. They have a conversation about Jason's aspirations, and the father admits he was wrong to stand in the way of his son's dreams. They come to an agreement, which is a positive resolution. The next day, Sister Sophia spends the night parked in front of Jason's house. She becomes enraged when she sees Sarah with Jason again. However, Zoe also notices Sophia's vehicle stalking their house. During the mass, Sophia's hateful gaze toward Jason is noticeable, and Zoe observes this. Zoe leaves the church to investigate the stalker's vehicle and tries to find its owner. Back at his room, Jason discovers Sister Sophia in his bed, pretending to have overdosed. Jason performs CPR on her, but she fakes it. Thank goodness he didn't perform chest compressions. Jason wants to report the incident to Father Macy, but Sister Sophia threatens to release their video if he does. In class, Sister Rebecca notices that Sophia did not participate in the prayer. Following this, an announcement is made that Sarah's suspension has ended, and she returns to class, which upsets Sophia. As Sarah flirts with Jason, Sophia interrupts them to tell Jason to stop interacting with Sarah. Despite this, Jason continues, which infuriates Sophia. While taking a shower, Sister Sophia eliminates Sarah by hitting her head against the wall and drops a bar of soap on the floor to make it look like an accident. Despite this, Jason and Zoe are not convinced that the incident was an accident, and suspect that Sophia might be responsible. In the church, Sophia shows Jason the video of their affair. Worried, Jason pleads with her to delete it, but Sophia threatens to spread it online if he does anything she disapproves of. At the end of the week, Sister Sophia claims that her aunt has passed away, and that she needs to attend the funeral. She is granted permission to leave. While Jason's family is out for dinner, they encounter Sister Sophia. Jason's father invites her to join them, despite Jason's reluctance. During dinner, Zoe begins asking questions and catches Sister Sophia in lie after lie. Afterward, Jason confides in Zoe that he has been sleeping with their teacher and is being blackmailed with the scandal video. Zoe informs Jason that she believes Sister Sophia is not who she claims to be. At school, Sister Rebecca calls Sophia to her office. When Sister Rebecca catches on to Sophia's lies and threatens to report her to Father Macy, Sophia knocks her out with a lamp. Determined to expose Sophia, Zoe, with Jason's help, breaks into her room and searches through her laptop. They uncover Sophia's true identity and her obsession with Jason, finding a folder titled Jason. They discover that her real name is Laura. At the chapel, Sophia approaches Jason and Zoe. When the siblings confront her about her behavior, Sophia attempts to persuade Jason to accompany her, but he refuses, calling her by her real name, Laura, and denouncing her as a crazy stalker who deserves to be locked up. Unwilling to accept that Jason does not love her, Sophia goes insane and strikes Zoe in the back of the head with a candlestick. When Jason tries to subdue her, Sophia knees him in the groin, claiming she is tired of everyone trying to keep her and Jason apart, and coldly admitting that she killed Sarah. Sophia intends to kill Zoe with the candlestick so she and Jason can be together forever, but Sister Rebecca intervenes. Sophia attacks Rebecca and tries to strangle her to death, but Jason stops her by stabbing her in the back with a screwdriver, much to Sophia's dismay. Gravely injured and saddened, Sophia collapses to the ground. On the day of graduation, Zoe's parents give her a car that belonged to their mother, while Jason receives a beautiful guitar. Jason plays the guitar as everyone listens and nods approvingly. For more videos similar to this, don't forget to subscribe and enable notifications. Thank you for watching.